Hello, everyone, and welcome to this edition of On the Legal Side, a radio program about the legal aspects of providing private security and law enforcement services. And today we're glad to have such great sponsors of the program. We'd like to just tell you about Bricks Fashions in Nashville, Tennessee. If you want to support the blue, if you want to back the blue, well, here's your chance. Bricks Fashions, men's and women's fashions. If you need an update, if you're looking for a new suit, a new dress, or you just want to refresh your whole closet, this is the place to go. Check them out today. Bricks Fashion, Nashville, Tennessee, owned by police chief there, the chief of Mount Juliet. You're definitely going to want to go in and check them out today. You can give them a call at 615-288-2604, 288-2604, or check them out online at bricksfashions.com. Also, another great sponsor today is 1-800-TIME-CLOCK, serving the public with time history stamping and products for years. Now they've got a great software that will track your security officers and verify that they've done their patrols. And you're going to want to check them out at 1-800.com. And of course, Body Armor USA, we've got what it takes to protect you. Check them out online today. They've got high quality stab vest, bulletproof vest, gloves, and an assortment of protection gear. 1-800. Call them up today. Body Armor USA. BodyArmorUSA.com. Today on the legal side, we're talking about assault. We're talking about putting your hands where they're not supposed to be. You know, a lot of times when I'm teaching across the country the use of force, and also when I teach, or even when our school, Armor College, teaches use of force online, we're never really surprised at the amount of students who believe that it's okay to touch you. It's okay to shove you. It's all okay to push you, to physically grapple with you, or to escort you off the property. I teach a lot, and I hear a lot of different responses from people. Security, law enforcement, college, public safety, all believe it somehow is still okay to touch someone, grab them, pull them, push them, or in some way, you know, put hands on them that's not legal. Is it legal? Is it an assault? Hey, let's find out today, because that's what the show is all about here on the legal side. Hands on or hands off? Unlawful, unwanted touching when you have no legal right to touch someone really does equate to and come down to at least simple assault. If you're doing some shopping, if you're in a restaurant and someone, whether it be an employee or the owner or security, decides that they don't like what you're saying or they don't like the way that you look and they tell you to leave and you don't leave, do they have a right to put their hands on you and escort you out? You know, we get a lot of this, especially from nightclub security and bouncers who just grew up with that philosophy, or maybe even teaching that makes them think that they can throw people out like the old days, pick them up by the scruff of their neck and the pants, seat of the pants, and just, bam, toss them out. You know, that times have changed. Things have changed. The law has changed. Really, when you touch someone unwanted, unlawfully, it's a simple assault. And it could be aggravated assault or felony assault if a weapon is used or implied. You don't have to have a weapon, you just have to imply that you have a weapon, or the person is injured due to you touching them and assaulting them. Now, the statutes do vary from state to state. That's why we always teach and we always tell people over and over and over again, know what the law is in your state. For instance, in Florida, 784.011, an assault is an intentional, unlawful threat by word or act. You don't even have to physically touch them. You just have to threaten them with an assault to do violence to the person or with an apparent ability to do so. If you have the ability to assault them, you don't have to physically lay hands on them. Doing so constitutes assault, a misdemeanor in the second degree. In Tennessee, the revised 2010 Tennessee Code Title 39, this will be 39-13-101, an assault is committed when a person intentionally or knowingly or recklessly causes bodily injury to another, intentionally or knowingly puts them in the fear of imminent injury, or intentionally or knowingly causes physical contact. You don't have to hurt them. You don't have to strike out at them. You just got to have physical contact. And a reasonable person would regard that contact as offensive or provocative. Assault is a Class A misdemeanor. The laws are different in every state, but the language is almost going to be the same. If you touch someone without their authority, without the legal just cause, you have probably committed at least a misdemeanor assault. And if you've injured them in any way, it could even be a felony aggravated assault. Know the state law, know the statutes, and know your limitations. Now, we're not talking, of course, about slapping somebody on the back, congratulating them for a great job, a great accomplishment. We're not saying that's an assault, because although the person might be shocked or might not be happy with that physical touch, you had no criminal intent to assault the person. In order to commit a crime, you have to have a form of criminal intent. And when you are giving a congratulatory slap on the back or whatever it might be, hey, yeah, great job, that's not an assault. Your intention was to congratulate them, and even though they may not really be happy with it, especially if you hit hard, nope. They may really not be thrilled, but it wasn't an assault. No criminal intent to do any type of bodily harm. No criminal intent to assault the person. On the other hand, if you bum rush somebody, you punch them, you hit them without warning, knock them in the head, sock them in the eye, because you didn't like what they were saying, you didn't like that they weren't listening to you, that they weren't obeying your authority, your commands, then that is an assault. And like I said earlier, we find this quite a bit when we're dealing with nightclub security and sometimes mall security, retail security. They just feel like they have that authority, that jurisdiction to lay hands, if you will, on a person and forcefully remove them from the property. Just like in the days of old, when you saw on the Westerns, somebody be tossed out on their butt from the tavern. But this isn't the Wild Wild West, and we have laws for a reason. Often, illegally touching a person who is not complying with your wishes, your demands, is going to be an assault. And probably even more than that. You could be charged with harassment, disorderly conduct, a number of different crimes. In one of our previous shows on the legal side, we talked about being an agent of the property. So you have to first have a legal authority. And if you are the agent of the property, you're the bouncer, the security officer, the public safety officer, the school resource, even a law enforcement officer, you have to have a legal right to touch somebody. When can you touch somebody? When can you reach out, you know, legally and touch them? The old force continuum training that used to be taught almost in every police academy and security school, force continuum, talked along the way about soft hands. And a lot of people through the years have gotten that to mean that it's okay to push somebody out of the way, okay to push somebody out of the store, okay to grab a hold of somebody and pull them out if they don't comply. But that's not okay, and that's not what it meant in that progression of force. Helping the person along just because they won't go on their own, just because they won't comply, they won't listen, doesn't mean you have a legal right to use, you know, self-help, helping them, helping you to comply. There's only two justified times in the law when we can use force. Only two times. Not whenever we please, not whenever, oh, I think it's okay, I think it's, you know, part of the force continuum. Whether you be a sworn or a non-sworn officer, the court says, the Constitution says, there's only two times that a person may use force. Here on the legal side, we want to make sure that you understand the law, that you comply with the law, that you don't get in trouble, that you don't make mistakes, wind up on the wrong side of the law. But if you're doing self-help, if you're pushing people along, if you're helping them out the door, then you are breaking the law. When we come back in part two, we're going to talk about those two times that you can touch somebody, those two times when you can use force, and how to avoid criminal charges or lawsuits against you for illegally touching someone and committing an assault. Today, on the legal side, we're talking about, you know, touching, legal or not legal, and are we breaking the law when we, you know, self-help a person out of the property or off the property? Stay with us. We'll be right back after this quick public service announcement.
Explosion, and I remember just opening my eyes, and it got both of my legs. I had surgery after surgery, and what's going to happen next? The Wounded Warrior Project said, look, brother, everything's going to be okay. 3 months from now, 4 months from now, a year from now, you'll be fine. I don't know if I would be as well adjusted as I am now if it wasn't for them.
To learn more, call 1-877-832-6997 or visit Wounded Warrior.
They say if you want a wish to come true, never tell anyone. But there is one wish that can make the difference between life and death. And this wish can only come true if you tell someone. Please let your family know you want to be an organ donor.
and welcome back to this edition of On the Legal Side, brought to you by Private Officer International, a security and law enforcement association. Visit them today at privateofficer.com. And if you're not already a member, you definitely want to be a member. More than 40 member benefits for public safety, private security, law enforcement, campus officers, bail and bondsmen, and investigators, and so forth. Anyone who's really involved in protecting life, protecting property. That's what we're all about. PrivateOfficer.com. I'm your host here, Rick McCann, founder and CEO of Private Officer. And today we're talking here on the legal side about what you legally can do, when you can do it, and how you can do it when it comes to touching people. We discussed here in the first top of the program, the first part, about what is assault. And it's classified a little differently in each state. The language is just a little bit different, but basically it all boils down to the same unwanted, illegal touching of a person, an individual. You know, just because you think you can do it doesn't mean that you should do it. And we find this often in nightclubs and sometimes with convenience store security. In my training across the country and in our classrooms, I use a lot of scenario-driven training. And here online today, let's give you a couple of examples of, you know, how you should react, what you should do in these situations. So you are a convenience store security officer, and you found the person on the side of the building, they're drinking a can of beer, they're loitering, and you've asked them to leave. They're telling you, yeah, whatever, I'll get to it when I get to it, don't worry about it. Well, a lot of times, security and law enforcement and people, in authoritative positions, that's not going to fit very well with them. They're not going to be very happy with that. I've told you to go. I've given you a directive, a command, an order, and I expect you to listen. I expect you to obey my authority. And sometimes the officer will continue to give that command. The person will ignore them, and eventually the officer may put hands on them, push them off the property, push them down, or some other physical contact to make the person understand what they're talking about. Well, here in the U.S., private and public officers, sworn and non-sworn, can only touch a person, can only use force for two reasons. One, to defend themselves or others, and two, to bring a non-compliant person into custody during an arrest. Only if that person, that private person especially, has the authority to make a lawful detention, private or citizen's person's arrest. We talk about what is a private person arrest many times, and basically, if your state allows you to arrest somebody for a misdemeanor or a felony, then you can use reasonable and minimal force to detain them. So if they're cooperating, or if they're not fighting you, then force is not warranted. There are several types of resistance, and in my use of force class, we talk about what those are. You need to become very familiar with that. You need to become very familiar with the Constitution. If you're not, you can study those things on your own. The internet these days has a lot of good information, but be sure that you get them from the right source, not just any old John Doe writing some blog someplace. Make sure that it's coming from somebody with credentials or a school. But in order to use force, even pushing someone, slapping someone, or grabbing somebody's arm and forcing them out of the property, off the property, out of the way, that is considered the use of force. And you only are legally justified in using force of any level, non-lethal or lethal, to protect yourself from being assaulted or imminent danger in the case of lethal force, or if you are have the legal authority to make an arrest and you are bringing someone into custody, effecting an arrest, and they are resisting and they are assaulting you and trying to injure you, then yes, you have the right to use reasonable force. It is unfortunate that many times people go off script. I mean, they go way off script sometimes. They only hear what they want to hear in training. They only think, they only react, they only do the thing they want to do. Remember, regardless of your position, even a public law enforcement can only use force to protect themselves and others and to bring someone into custody if they've broken the law. That's the Constitution. That's the law. If you're not sure whether or not, as a private security person, private officer, that you can take somebody into custody, or that your client or your employer wants you to take someone into custody, that's something that you have to rectify. That's something that you have to identify and find out immediately whether or not you're authorized. Because if you do take somebody into custody and you use force, and your client or your employer says, no, I didn't want him to do that. We observe and report. We don't do hands-on stuff. The chances may be better than good that you could face criminal charges of assault. And we've seen security officers arrested for unlawful restraint and kidnapping, also for taking somebody into custody, handcuffing them, holding them against their will. If you're not familiar with what a legal definition of an arrest is, or where in the Constitution it specifically talks about an arrest of a person, then you need to get that information. You need to clarify it. You need to train on it. I highly recommend that before using any level of force, that you get some authentic, detailed training. Going online and taking one of these 15-second courses and getting a certificate isn't going to get it. It's not going to qualify you in the real world. You want scenario-driven, hands-on training where you can be in the reality of the situation. You want to be able to fully be engrossed in that training subject. Many things are changing in the world and the law. Tactics are changing. What type of equipment you can carry, what type of force you can use, when you can use it. I see a lot of security personnel especially carrying all sorts of gear on their belt and all of that. It's great. But my friend, I highly recommend that you get really trained and certified by a real certified instructor. Not just anybody at any old company, because that's not going to hold up in court. Remember, you cannot use soft hands to push someone off the property or out of the building. You cannot take somebody by the scruff of their neck like in the old days and throw them out of the bar. That's assault. All right, well, that's going to do it for this episode of On the Legal Side. Remember, be safe. And, just get that training that you need. Until the next time, be safe, be blessed. We'll see you back here on the radio.